Australian father and writer Yang Hengjun has been sentenced to death by a secret Chinese court over contested espionage charges. The Albanese government says it's appalled by the move. Dr. Yang's family face the prospect of never seeing him again.
Pro-democracy activist, writer and Australian father Yang Hengjun is now a condemned man.
We understand that this can be commuted to a life sentence following 2 years.
That is, he will be executed by order of a Chinese court if he doesn't behave.
The Australian government is appalled at this outcome.
Dr. Yang spent more than 4 years in a Beijing prison on national security charges, China's claims of espionage firmly rejected by his family and the Australian government.
I would note that Australian officials were not able to attend Dr. Yang's trial in 2021.
Dr. Yang's family is shattered by the sentence, saying it was at the extreme end of worst expectations. Following release of Australian journalist Cheng Lei last year, they wrote to the Prime Minister hoping for a second miracle, sharing Dr. Yang's own words. "I haven't enjoyed any direct sunlight for over 4 years," he told them. "Don't worry about me. The Australian government are paying attention to my case. I just hope I will be able to get out alive."
It's an outrageous political persecution.
Sydney academic Feng Chongyi says the case against his friend was fabricated.
He had done nothing wrong. He does not commit any crime of espionage.
The quiet diplomacy approach of the government thus far has not been effective. This needs to be elevated to the highest possible political level.
We cannot allow Dr. Yang's case to slide from view. It must remain a top priority for the Albanese government.
The Chinese ambassador this afternoon summoned for a diplomatic dressing down.
Ambassador, how is this not a barbaric sentence?
Andrew Probyn, Nine News. The Albanese government's attempts to normalise Australia's relationship with China are unravelling, and the stakes are now even higher. But the particular menace in Yang Hengjun's suspended death sentence is that it might intimidate his friends and family from speaking out, which means this may only end well for the Australian writer if the Prime Minister takes it up directly with the Chinese president. Pete?
Andrew, thank you.